I have a very special guest on the other side of the line. Hello, Everson, can you hear me?
Sure, man, what's up?
I saw your latest video about threaded inserts, and it really makes me curious. What size of the bolt you use there?
Oh, you're gonna test it! That would be awesome! It was an M6 bolt, but you have to sand the head, you know?
Sure, give me a week and I will check if the connection is stronger. We'll see you later, maybe at the end of the video.
Let's do this, yeah!
Hey, welcome back. This work is some kind of extension to video published by Gigditor, where my friend Everson presents different methods how can we insert those threaded inserts to be flat with the surface. If you are not familiar with the threaded inserts, check his video. Maybe just one thing I would like to add. One of the biggest advantages of these tools is the removability of the bolt. So in case you want to insert and remove that bolt several times, definitely you should avoid those screws which will cut the thread into plastic or the wood. I will test three different methods. The first one will be pressing the insert against the desk. The second one will be with Everson's secret tool.
For that, I have a secret tool.
Yes, pressing the insert with the bolt. And since they have some conical ending, they will press the insert a little bit deeper and with this resulting a little bit more melted plastic around it, maybe this will result a stronger connection. We will see. And the third one will be just pressing down with a soldering iron to be just slightly below the surface. And for this I will not use any special tools, so probably the repeatability will not be too good. Different depth and similar, but in that case, I don't know, even the standard deviation may be considered as a result too. Before you jump forward into video, what do you think, which method will be the strongest? I think the difference will be measurable, but not significant. But we will see soon. First, I have to prepare my bolt. I will use M5 and I'm using the lathe machine to remove those numbers, specifications for the material. Nice and flat. And I'm measuring the cylindrical part, very important because I have to create a hole for it. And I know that I have to design a little bit bigger hole because when it will be printed, it will be a little bit smaller. And the bigger diameter is just for the aligning during the test. For these test objects, I'm using 5 valves and 50% infill. This is Polymaker PLA Pro in red color, and I will print everything on BamboLab A1 printer. The hole has the perfect size because that cylindrical part tightly goes in, and I prepared all 9 test objects. And now it's time to prepare my soldering iron. I have this tip, I made it from the old bolt, quite ugly but it's functional. I'm starting with the first group, first inserting with the soldering iron, then when it is almost completely in, I'm pressing it against the desk, and then it will be completely flat with the surface, and all three objects are prepared. The next group, similar start, pressing with the soldering iron, but then pressing in with this bolt. And again, all three test objects are prepared, they are marked with number 2. And the third group is just pressing down with the soldering iron slightly below the surface. It will be nice to press in with the bolt, but I will not touch it. The third group is also prepared and they look very similar to me, so I hope the repeatability will be quite good. Everything is prepared for the measuring. I started with testing using this M3 eye bolt. And as you can see, it deformed at approximately 30-35 kilograms. So not really good for my application, completely deformed, so I made a stronger connection. I hope this will be strong enough. And here you can see me in action. And what size of the load I have to pull. The average here are 140 kilograms. And let's move to group number 2. Which was pressed in with the bolt. Just a little bit bigger load, 147 kilograms average. And the third group pressed with the soldering iron below the surface. And it looks like this is the strongest from these three. And this is how these inserts look like now after the testing. Very similar in all 9 cases. We can analyze the results to see which method is the strongest. We can watch the percentage or analyze the graph. But actually, for me, the real conclusion from this is that all three methods are very strong. I mean, 140, 150 kilogram pulling out load, that's incredibly strong for M3 bolt. Now we have to clear something. There are two main groups of the application. With first one, that object we want to attach with the bolt will align to that insert or the surface. In that case, no matter how we tight it, actually the pulling out load will be the first failure there. But there are applications where we have some gap between that insert and attached object. In this case, the applied torque may pull out this insert. The question is how big torque will start pulling out this threaded insert. Now, for your information, with the standard screwdriver, we can apply, let's say, 3.5 Nm torque. I tried the my torque, which I usually use for M3 bolt, is a little bit below 1 Nm. Officially, actually, the 1 Nm is the maximum for M3 bolts, 1.3 for some stronger material bolt. But the question is, are we still in a safe zone? Or with this torque, we will start pulling out the threaded insert. So let's try to answer this question. And again, I needed some DIY hacks. I was playing a little bit with my lathe and milling machine, creating these two parts. That this sensor is from the brass. The new test objects are printed from the Bamboo Lab Marble PLA. The measure of the hole is perfect again. I will have two test objects. The first one will be the version pressed against the desk. Nice and flat. And there will be another one, and this one will be pressed in with the bolt. You can see it is deeper a little bit. Now I am using here this brass distancer. With this I will reduce this torque, but in real application probably you will use something from steel, for example. And in this case actually this real torque will be a little bit bigger. The maximal torque was 0.8 Nm, quite disappointing. And this insert looks very similar to those which I pulled out earlier. This one should be stronger a little bit because it is pressed in with this bolt and it's a little bit deeper. And now let's repeat this test, and on pull-out test this bolt method was a little bit stronger. Let's see if this will be the case here with the torque.
0.9 Nm,
so slightly stronger, but I'm still not too happy with these results. This was an interesting surprise. I thought the torque would be much bigger. Now this means that if we don't have any object immediately above the threaded surface and there is a chance that it may be pulled out, you have to be very careful how big torque you will apply to it. If you do have an object above it, in that case maybe pressing against the desk would be much better, because in that case it will be flattened with the surface and immediately when you apply some torque to it, it will align to that surface above it. Two more bonus tests. Let's say we print a hole and with the tap tool we cut the thread into it.
Thread cut into the plastic.
I'm using this method very often, but only with the bigger threads.
0.3 Nm.
And this method I'm using very often exactly with M3 threads. I printed here a 2.8 mm hole. And then this bolt will cut the thread into it. And for this feeling it is stronger. And measuring the torque, this will be around 1 Nm. So for the first thought, this is strong. Yes, but very important thing to remember, that this can we do only once. If we remove the bolt, and later we want to reuse it, since the threads are partly damaged, the connection will be very weak. So this method can be used only if you use the bolt once, without removing it. Interesting data. First, I'm surprised with how big force we need to pull out these threaded inserts, but at the other side, how small torque is enough to pull them out. Now, these are one of the smallest M3 threaded inserts I could buy, 5 mm in diameter, and the total length is also 5 mm. There are bigger ones too, and maybe I should upgrade, because in some applications, this torque may be not enough. There are so many tests about threaded inserts on YouTube, and I hope somebody will test this with this method, measuring different size M3 inserts, measuring the torque necessary to pull this out. I'm very curious about this. I hope I don't have to do it myself. Everson, what's your opinion about the results?
Oh, no, man, you should test it. Everybody loves to see you testing. Yeah, I am a little bit disappointed that the strongest one is the ugliest, you know, in the top, but I will continue using the flat. Your results opened more questions. We need to talk later. Yeah, we will talk later. Man, thank you so much for testing it. It's a great thing.
You're welcome. Thank you for watching and happy printing.